This channel has been established for visually impaired people. For the visually impaired people, voice narration and a written expression are also provided for the hearing impaired. Don't forget to subscribe to our channel. Presidential election results map. Red denotes states won by Hayes, Wheeler. Blue denotes those won by Tilden. Hendricks numbers indicate the number of electoral votes allotted to each state president before election. Ulysses S. Grant, Republican, elected president. Rutherford B. Hayes, Republican. The United States presidential election of 1876 was the 23rd quadrennial presidential election, held on Tuesday, November 7, 1876. It was one of the most contentious and controversial presidential elections in American history. The results of the election remain among the most disputed ever, although it isn't disputed that Samuel J. Tilden of New York outpolled Ohio's Rutherford B. Hayes in the popular vote after a first count of votes. Tilden won 184 electoral votes to Hayes's 165, with 20 votes unresolved. These 20 electoral votes were in dispute in four states in the case of Florida, Louisiana, and South Carolina. Each party reported its candidate had won the state, while in Oregon one elector was replaced after being declared illegal for being an elected or appointed official. The question of who should have been awarded these electoral votes is the source of the continued controversy concerning the results of this election. An informal deal was struck to resolve the dispute, the Compromise of 1877, which awarded all 20 electoral votes to Hayes in return for the Democrats' acquiescence to Hayes's election. The Republicans agreed to withdraw federal troops from the South to end the Reconstruction era of the United States. The compromise effectively ceded power in the Southern states to the Democratic Redeemers, who went on to pursue their agenda of returning the South to a political economy resembling that of its pre-war condition, including the disenfranchisement of black voters. This was the first presidential election since 1852 in which the Democratic candidate won a majority of the popular vote. This is also the only election in which a candidate for president received more than 50% of the popular vote, but was not elected president by the Electoral College, and one of five elections in addition to 1824, 1888, 2000, and 2016 in which the person who won the most popular votes did not win the election. To date, it remains the election that recorded the smallest electoral vote victory and the election that yielded the highest voter turnout of the eligible voting age population in American history, at 818%. Contents 1 nominations 11 Republican Party nomination 12 Democratic Party nomination 13 Greenback Party nomination 131 Candidates Gallery 14 Prohibition Party nomination 15 American National Party nomination 2 General Election 21 Campaign 22 Colorado 23 Electoral Disputes 24 Results 25 Geography of Results 251 Cartographic Gallery 26 Results by State 27 Close States 3 Popular Culture 4 See also 5 References 6 Reference and further reading 61 Primary sources 7 External links Nominations Republican Party nomination Main article, 1876 Republican National Convention Republican candidates, Governor Rutherford B. Hayes of Ohio Senator James G. Blaine from Maine Secretary of the Treasury Benjamin Bristow Senator Oliver P. Morton from Indiana Senator Roscoe Conkling from New York Governor John F. Hartranft of Pennsylvania Postmaster General Marshall Jewell Ambassador Elihu B. Washburn from Illinois Representative William A. Wheeler from New York President Ulysses S. Grant declined in 1875 Hayes, Wheeler campaign poster It was widely assumed during the year 1875 that incumbent President Ulysses S. Grant would run for a third term as president in spite of the poor economic conditions, the numerous political scandals that had developed since he assumed office in 1869, and a long-standing tradition set by the first president, George Washington, not to stay in office longer than two terms Grant's inner circle advised him to go for a third term and he almost did, but the House, by a sweeping 233-18 vote, passed a resolution declaring that the two-term tradition was to prevent a dictatorship late in the year. The president withdrew from the running for 1876 when the 6th Republican National Convention assembled on June 14, 1876. It appeared that James G. Blaine would be the nominee on the first ballot. Blaine was just 100 votes short of a majority. His vote began to slide after the second ballot. However, as many Republicans feared that Blaine could not win the general election, anti-Blaine delegates could not agree on a candidate until Blaine's total rose to 41% on the sixth ballot. Leaders of the Reform Republicans met privately and considered alternatives. Their choice was Ohio's Reform Governor, Rutherford B. Hayes, on the seventh ballot. Hayes was nominated with 384 votes to 351 for Blaine. and 21 for Benjamin Bristow. William A. Wheeler was nominated for vice president by a much larger margin, 366-89, over his chief rival, Frederick Theodore Frelinghuysen, who later served as a member of the Electoral Commission that awarded the election to Hayes. Presidential ballot. Ballot 1st, 2nd, 3rd, 4th, 5th, 6th, 7th. James G. Blaine, 285,296,293,292,286. 308,351. Oliver P. Morton, 124,120,113,108,95,85. O. Benjamin Bristow, 113,114,121,126,114,111,21. Roscoe Conkling, 99,93,90,84,82,81. O. Rutherford B. Hayes, 61,64,67,68,104,113,384. John F. Hartranft, 58,63,68,71,69,50. O. Marshall Jewell, 11,00,00,00. William A. Wheeler, 332,222,000. Elihu B. Washburn, 0113340. Republican presidential nomination vote by state delegation by ballot. 6th presidential ballot. 7th presidential ballot. Vice presidential ballot. Ballot 1st partial. William A. Wheeler, 366. Frederick T. Frelinghuysen, 89. Stuart L. Woodford, 70. Marshall Jewell, 38. Joseph R. Hawley, 25. Republican vice presidential nomination vote by state delegation. Main article, 1876 Democratic National Convention. Democratic candidates, Samuel J. Tilden, Governor of New York. Thomas A. Hendricks, Governor of Indiana. Winfield Scott Hancock, United States Army Major General from Pennsylvania. William Allen, former Governor of Ohio. Thomas F. Bayard, U.S. Senator from Delaware. Joel Parker, former Governor of New Jersey. Governor Samuel J. Tilden of New York. Governor Thomas A. Hendricks of Indiana. Major General Winfield Scott Hancock from Pennsylvania. William Allen from Ohio. Senator Thomas F. Bayard from Delaware. Joel Parker from New Jersey. Interior of the Merchants Exchange Building of St. Louis, Missouri. During the announcement of Samuel J. Tilden as the Democratic presidential nominee, Tilden, Hendricks campaign poster. The 12th Democratic National Convention assembled in St. Louis, Missouri, in June 1876, the first political convention held by one of the major American parties west of the Mississippi River. 5,000 people jammed the auditorium in St. Louis with hopes for the first presidential victory for the Democratic Party in 20 years. The platform called for immediate and sweeping reforms in response to the scandals that had plagued the Grant administration. Tilden won more than 400 votes on the first ballot and the nomination by a landslide on the second. Tilden defeated Thomas A. Hendricks, Winfield Scott Hancock, William Allen, Thomas F. Bayard, and Joel Parker for the presidential nomination. Although Tilden was strongly opposed by Honest John Kelly, the leader of New York's Tammany Hall, he was still able to obtain the nomination. Thomas Hendricks was nominated for vice president, since he was the only person put forward for the position. The Democratic platform pledged to replace the corruption of the Grant administration with honest, efficient government and to end the rapacity of carpetbag tyrannies in the South. It also called for treaty protection for naturalized United States citizens visiting their homelands, restrictions on Asian immigration, tariff reform, and opposition to land grants for railroads. It has been claimed that Tilden's nomination was received by the voting Democrats with more enthusiasm than any leader since Andrew Jackson. Presidential ballot. First before shifts. First after shifts. Second before shifts. Second after shifts. Unanimous. Samuel J. Tilden, 4015-4175-535-534-738. Thomas A. Hendricks, 1405-1405-8560. Winfield Scott Hancock, 75-75-58-59. William Allen, 54-54-54-54. Thomas F. Bayard, 33-33-4-11. Joel Parker, 18-18-0-18. James Broadhead, 16-0-0-0. Allen G. Thurman, 0022. Democratic presidential nomination vote by state delegation by ballot. Vice presidential ballot. First Thomas A. Hendricks, 730 blank 8. Source: Official Proceedings of the National Democratic Convention, held in St. Louis, Mo., June 27, 28th and 29th, 1876. September 3, 2012. Greenback Party nomination. Main article, 1876 Greenback Party National Convention. Greenback candidates, Peter Cooper, U.S. philanthropist from New York. Andrew Curtin, former governor of Pennsylvania. William Allen, former governor of Ohio. Ohio Alexander Campbell, U.S. Representative from Illinois Candidates Gallery Philanthropist Peter Cooper from New York Andrew Curtin from Pennsylvania. William Allen from Ohio. The Greenback Party had been organized by agricultural interests in Indianapolis in 1874 to urge the federal government to inflate the economy through the mass issuance of paper money called greenbacks. Its first national nominating convention was held in Indianapolis in the spring of 1876. Peter Cooper was nominated for president with 352 votes to 119 for three other contenders. The convention nominated anti-monopolist Senator Newton Booth of California for vice president. After Booth declined to run, the National Committee chose Samuel Fenton Carey as his replacement on the ticket. Presidential ballot. Ballot first: Peter Cooper 352, Andrew Curtin 58, William Allen 31, Alexander Campbell 30. Source: U.S. President, G. Convention. Our campaigns. February 10, 2012. Prohibition Party nomination. The Prohibition Party, in its second national convention, nominated Green Clay Smith as its presidential candidate and Gideon T. Stewart as its vice presidential candidate. American National Party nomination. This small political party used several different names, often with different names in different states. It was a continuation of the anti-Masonic party that met in 1872 and nominated Charles Francis Adams for president when Adams declined to run. The party did not contest the 1872 election. The convention was held from June 8 to 10, 1875, in Liberty Hall, Pittsburgh. B.T. Roberts of New York served as chairman, and Jonathan Blanchard was the keynote speaker. The platform supported the Reconstruction amendments to the Constitution, international arbitration, the reading of the scriptures in public schools, specie payments, justice for Native Americans, abolition of the Electoral College, and prohibition of the sale of alcoholic beverages. It declared the first day of the week to be a day of rest for the United States. The platform opposed secret societies and monopolies. The convention considered three potential presidential nominees: Charles F. Adams, Jonathan Blanchard, and James B. Walker. When Blanchard declined to run, Walker was unanimously nominated. The convention then nominated Donald Kirkpatrick of New York unanimously for vice president. General election campaign. The election was hotly contested, as can be seen by this poster published in 1877. A certificate for the electoral vote for Rutherford B. Hayes and William A. Wheeler for the state of Louisiana. A truce, not a compromise, but a chance for high-toned gentlemen to retire gracefully from their very civil declarations of war. War by Thomas Nast in Harper's Weekly, 1877. February 17, p. 132. Tilden, who had prosecuted machine politicians in New York and sent legendary political boss William M. Tweed to jail, ran as a reform candidate against the background of the corruption of the Grant administration. Both parties backed civil service reform and an end to Reconstruction. Both sides mounted mud-slinging campaigns, with Democratic attacks on Republican corruption being countered by Republicans raising the Civil War issue, a tactic ridiculed by Democrats who called it waving the bloody shirt. Republicans chanted, "Not every Democrat was a rebel, but every rebel was a Democrat." Hayes was a virtual unknown outside his home state of Ohio, where he had served two terms as a congressman and then two terms as governor. Henry Adams wrote, "Is a third-rate nonentity whose only recommendations are that he is obnoxious to no one." He had served in the Civil War with distinction as colonel of the 23rd Ohio Regiment and was wounded several times, which made him marketable to veterans. Hayes's most important asset was the help he provided the Republican ticket in carrying the crucial swing state of Ohio. The Democratic strategy for victory in the South was highly reliant on paramilitary groups such as the Red Shirts and the White League. Using the strategy of the Mississippi Plan, these groups actively suppressed black and white Republican voter turnouts by disrupting meetings and rallies and even using violence and intimidation. They saw themselves as the military wing of the Democratic Party. The South Carolina Democratic Party, however, made genuine efforts to recruit black voters. Its gubernatorial candidate, former Confederate General Wade Hampton, said at his first campaign speech on the 16th of September, "If there is a white man in this assembly who believes when I am elected governor that I will stand between him and the law, or grant to him any immunities or privileges that shall not be granted to the colored man, he is mistaken, and I tell him so now." South Carolina Democrats were so successful in peacefully recruiting black voters that hundreds of blacks put on red shirts and marched alongside their counterparts. This led to violence in Charleston. Because it was considered improper for a candidate to pursue the presidency actively, neither Tilden nor Hayes actively stumped as part of the campaign, leaving that job to surrogates. Colorado. Colorado was admitted to the Union as the 38th state on August 1, 1876, with insufficient time or money to organize a presidential election in the new state. Colorado's state legislature selected the state's electors. These electors in turn gave their three votes to Hayes and the Republican Party. This was the last election in which any state chose electors through its state legislature. Electoral disputes. Further information: Electoral Commission. United States in Florida with 4 electoral votes, Louisiana with 8, and South Carolina with 7. Reported returns favored Tilden, but election results in each state were marked by fraud and threats of violence against Republican voters. One of the points of contention revolved around the design of ballots at the time. Parties would print ballots or tickets to enable voters to support them in the open ballots to aid illiterate voters. The parties would print symbols on the tickets in this election. Many Democratic ballots were printed with the Republican symbol, Abraham Lincoln, on them. The Republican-dominated state electoral commission subsequently disallowed a sufficient number of Democratic votes to award their electoral votes to Hayes. Republicans, however, were also guilty of voter fraud and intimidation and simply used their control of the election returning boards to cast out enough Democratic votes to fabricate Republican popular vote majorities in each state. According to historian Roy Morris, the actions of the returning boards would not bear close scrutiny. Any reasonably impartial board was likely to reverse the findings, particularly for Louisiana. In 2 southern states, the governor recognized by the United States had signed the Republican certificates. The Democratic certificates from Florida were signed by the state attorney general and the new Democratic governor. Those from Louisiana were signed by the Democratic gubernatorial candidate, and those from South Carolina by no state official in the latter state. The Tilden electors simply claimed that they were chosen by the popular vote, and they were rejected by the state election board. Meanwhile, in Oregon, the vote of a single elector was disputed. The statewide result clearly favored Hayes, but the state's Democratic governor, Lafayette Grover, claimed that one elector, former postmaster John Watts, was ineligible under Article 2, Section 1, of the United States Constitution, since he was a person holding an office of trust or profit under the United States. Grover then substituted a Democratic elector in his place. The 2 Republican electors dismissed Grover's action and each reported 3 votes for Hayes, while the Democratic elector, C.A. Cronin, reported 1 vote for Tilden and 2 votes for Hayes. The 2 Republican electors presented a certificate signed by the Secretary of State of Oregon Cronin and the 2 electors he appointed. Cronin voted for Tilden while his associates voted for Hayes. Used a certificate signed by the governor and attested by the Secretary of State. Ultimately, all 3 of Oregon's votes were awarded to Hayes. Hayes thus had a majority of 1 in the Electoral College. The Democrats cried fraud. Suppressed excitement pervaded the country. Threats were even muttered that Hayes would never be inaugurated in Columbus, Ohio. A shot was fired at Governor Hayes's residence as he sat down to dinner. Supporters marched to his home, calling for the president. Hayes urged the crowd that it is impossible, at so early a time, to obtain the result. President Grant quietly strengthened the military force in and around Washington. The Constitution provides that the president of the Senate shall, in presence of the Senate and House of Representatives, open all the certificates, and the votes shall then be counted. Certain Republicans held that the power to count the votes lay with the President of the Senate, the House and Senate being mere spectators. The Democrats objected to this construction, since Mr. Ferry, the Republican President of the Senate, could then count the votes of the disputed states for Hayes. The Democrats insisted that Congress should continue the practice followed since 1865, which was that no vote objected to should be counted except by the concurrence of both houses. The House had a solid Democratic majority. By throwing out the vote of one state, it could elect Tilden, facing an unprecedented constitutional crisis. The Congress of the United States passed a law on January 29, 1877 that formed a 15-member electoral commission to settle the result. 5 members were selected from each House of Congress, and they were joined by 5 members of the Supreme Court. William M. Evarts served as counsel for the Republican Party. The Compromise of 1877 might have helped the Democrats accept this electoral commission as well. The majority party in each House named 3 members and the minority party 2, as the Republicans controlled the Senate and the Democrats the House of Representatives. This yielded 5 Democratic and 5 Republican members of the commission of the Supreme Court justices. 2 Republicans and 2 Democrats were chosen, with the 5th to be selected by these 4. The justices first selected a political independent, Justice David Davis. According to one historian, 01, perhaps not even Davis himself, knew which presidential candidate he preferred. Just as the Electoral Commission bill was passing Congress, the legislature of Illinois elected Davis to the Senate. Democrats in the Illinois legislature believed that they had purchased Davis's support by voting for him. However, they had made a miscalculation. Instead of staying on the Supreme Court so that he could serve on the commission, he promptly resigned as a justice in order to take his Senate seat. All the remaining available justices were Republicans, so the four justices already selected chose Justice Joseph P. Bradley, who was considered the most impartial remaining member of the court. This selection proved decisive. Results by county explicitly indicating the percentage of the winning candidate in each county. Shades of blue are for Tilden Democratic and shades of red are for Hayes Republican. It was drawing perilously near to Inauguration Day. The commission met on the last day of January. The cases of Florida, Louisiana, Oregon, and South Carolina were in succession submitted to it by Congress. Eminent counsel appeared for each side. There were double sets of returns from every one of the states named. The commission first decided not to question any returns that were prima facie lawful. Bradley joined the other seven Republican committee members in a series of 8-7 votes that gave all 20 disputed electoral votes to Hayes, giving Hayes a 185-184 electoral vote victory. The commission adjourned on March 2. 2 days later, Hayes was inaugurated without disturbance. During intense closed-door meetings, Democratic leaders agreed with reluctance to accept Hayes as president in return for the withdrawal of federal troops from the last two still-occupied southern states. South Carolina and Louisiana Republican leaders in return agreed on a number of handouts and entitlements, including federal subsidies for a transcontinental railroad line through the South, although some of these promises were not kept. In particular, the railroad proposal, it was enough for the time being to avert a dangerous standoff. The returns accepted by the commission put Hayes' margin of victory in South Carolina at 889 votes, the second closest popular vote margin in a decisive state in U.S. history, after the election of 2000, which was decided by 537 votes in Florida. Though in 2000, the declared margin of victory in the Electoral College for George W. Bush was 5 votes, as opposed to Hayes' 1 vote, it is not possible to conclude definitively what the result would have been if a fair election had been held without the violence and intimidation throughout the South that disenfranchised many African Americans made eligible to vote under the 15th Amendment. Nevertheless, in the likeliest fair scenario, Hayes would have won the election with 189 electoral votes to Tilden's 180 by winning all of the states that he did ultimately carry, plus Mississippi, but minus Florida. In a truly fair election, it seems probable that South Carolina, Mississippi, and Louisiana, which all had majority black populations, would have gone Republican regardless. Hayes would be the last Republican until Dwight D. Eisenhower in 1956 to win the electoral votes of Louisiana, and the last Republican until Barry M. Goldwater in 1964 to carry South Carolina. Florida, with a majority white population, would have likely gone to Tilden in a fair election. It is therefore likely that Hayes would have won appreciably more of the popular vote in a fair election, perhaps even a plurality or majority upon his defeat. Tilden said, "I can retire to public life with the consciousness that I shall receive from posterity the credit of having been elected to the highest position in the gift of the people, without any of the cares and responsibilities of the office." Hayes, however, chose to pay off those who helped him win the Electoral College with government sinecures. Democratic governors soon replaced carpetbag Republicans in the three disputed southern states, but Hayes arranged appointments of the former GOP governors and other state officials who helped him win the election. Louisiana's 1876 gubernatorial candidate became the U.S. Consul to Liverpool, and the outgoing governor who signed the returns sent to Washington moved up to the U.S. Senate in a deal arranged by Ohio Senator John Sherman, who was the younger brother of General of the Army William T. Sherman. The 4-2 white and 2 black members of Louisiana's election board were given federal posts. One of the white men was appointed the chief customs collector in New Orleans, and the other became his assistant. Customs posts were notoriously corrupt during that era. One of the blacks became a deputy naval officer at the port, and the other got a customs house post for his brother. In total, 69 men involved in the Republican winning Louisiana count were rewarded with federal appointments. In all, some 50 relatives and friends of the Louisiana returning board got positions at the New Orleans customs house. Results according to the Commission's rulings, of the 2,249 counties and independent cities making returns, Tilden won in 1,301 5,785%, while Hayes carried only 947 4,211%. 1 county 004% in Nevada split evenly between Tilden and Hayes. The election of 1876 was the last one held before the end of the Reconstruction era, which sought to protect the rights of African Americans in the South who usually voted for Republican presidential candidates. It was not until the election of 1920 that one of the states of the Confederacy was ever again carried by a Republican presidential candidate. In that case, it was Tennessee, a state that never experienced a long period of occupation by federal troops and was completely reconstructed well before the first presidential election of the Reconstruction period, 1868. None of the southern states that experienced long periods of occupation by federal troops was carried by a Republican again until the election of 1928. Texas, Florida, North Carolina, and Virginia presidential candidate party home state popular vote electoral. Vote running mate count PCT vice presidential candidate home state elect vote Rutherford B. Hayes Republican Ohio 4,034,142 4,792% 185 William A. Wheeler New York 185 Samuel J. Tilden Democratic New York 4,286,808 5,092% 184 Thomas A. Hendricks Indiana 184 Peter Cooper Greenback New York 83,726 099% 0 Samuel Fenton Carey Ohio 0 Green Clay Smith Prohibition Kentucky 6,945 008% 0 Gideon T. Stewart Ohio 0 James Walker American National Party Illinois 463,001% 0 Donald Kirkpatrick New York 0 Other 6,575 008% Other, total 8,418,659 100% 369,369 needed to win 185,185 popular vote Tilden. 4,792% Cooper. Map of Democratic presidential election results by county. Map of Republican presidential election results by county. Map of other presidential election results by county. Cartogram of presidential election results by county. Cartogram of Democratic presidential election results by county. Cartogram of Republican presidential election results by county. Cartogram of other presidential election results by county. Results by state. Source: data from Walter Dean Burnham, Presidential Ballots, 1836-1892. Johns Hopkins University Press, 1955, pp. 247-57. States won by Tilden, Hendricks. States won by Hayes, Wheeler. Samuel J. Tilden Democratic, Rutherford B. Hayes Republican, Peter Cooper Greenback. Green Smith Prohibition Margin. State total. State electoral votes hash. Votes hash. 34,281 1997 171,699 Al Arkansas 658,086 5,992 638,649 3987 211-022 19,437 2005 96,946 R. California 676,460 4,908 79,258 5088 6 47 003